I think I would say the song "Jeg er guden I atjenerne," which is from my my first album. And the reason would be that, I don't know, I felt when I did it that I kind of hit something new, which helped me visualize where I wanted to go next. So in that sense, it kind of influenced me where I wanted to, my next step. And I don't know, it's become my favorite song to do live as well. Well, I grew up in a music house and my father was a musician, and so I think that I just did, because all the instruments were there already. So I don't have that moment of, oh, this one person influenced me, as much as just my life, I guess. My favorite thing is pastries and coffee, and I'm sure it would be dull at some point, but that's my answer. There's not one band. I mean, I think as of life experiences, I have memories that made a very big impression on me. For example, seeing, you know, a Danish symphony orchestra with a men's choir and a boys' choir, and I believe some girls as well, and a soprano performing all of Tim Burton's scores in the concert hall in Copenhagen. That's something that really stuck with me. I think it's too hard to say just one band live. A whole forest on the stage and 100 virgins singing backing vocals for me. If I had to, for example, write with somebody, I think it would be interesting to write with Lana Del Rey, somebody like that. I think she captures a very cool kind of dark universe, and she made her whole life into her work of art. I think that's cool. But it would be fun to just, you know, just to work with Rihanna, just for the hell of it, but I don't know. Have my own farm and just nothing industrial, but more just like being able to live off of plants and animals, and just like a little culture there. And so it's not really a profession so much as just a lifestyle I'd like to have that I can't have right now. I'd like to hang out with the Hans Christian Andersen, the Danish fairy tale author. He seemed to have a lot of crazy kind of... I'd like to know what went on in his head. I actually one time stayed at a castle that he used to live in. He was renting... It's not really a castle, it's a gus. I don't know what that's called in English. So he had rented a little tiny room there, and was writing a lot in there. And I stayed in that very room, which freaked me out a little bit, I remember. There was some dark energy happening, but I don't know. I think we would have some strong liquor and talk about Little Mermaid, maybe. So it's not really a tour story so much as it's I performed at the mausoleum in outside of Oslo, which is the artist who made it. It's basically his own grave. And it's got 11 seconds of reverb in there, and it's just painted all over the walls with these very dark paintings of dead, naked people. And it's just a stunning room. And performing in there with my girls' choir was just something that I will never forget. And I also even made a record from it, so that was nice. And then afterwards, I had a lot of friends who came to that concert, and we had a very nice night. So. I tend to pick up way too many things when I'm walking out in nature, so I have my whole house is like, there's just branches and stones, and yeah, it's alive. So I pick up way too many things like that, but I don't have a collection like some people collect certain vinyls, or I don't really have that.
Do you collect instruments? Musical?
Yeah, I guess I'm an instrument hoarder, but weird instruments, you know. I just fall for all these. I see these older folk instruments or medieval instruments, and I need to have them and I need to learn how to play them. So that's something I do a lot.